In this video, we're going to take a look at computing the mean and standard deviation for a binomial distribution, also called the expected value and the standard deviation. We're going to look at doing this two different ways. We're going to look at doing it using the formulas, and we're also going to take a look at how to do this in the calculator. So if we want to compute mu and sigma for a binomial probability distribution. The other name that you'll hear the mean referred to by is also you'll hear it referred to as the expected value for the binomial probability distribution. This is actually the most commonly occurring value, and so in many ways it's the value that we will expect to occur when we're dealing with a binomial probability distribution. So again, you can do this two different ways. You can do it with the formula, or you can do it on the calculator. If you choose to use the formulas, they're actually very straightforward. The mean of a binomial probability distribution is equal to n times p, the probability of success on any given trial times the total number of trials, and that will give us our expected value. The standard deviation is the square root of n, the number of trials, times p, the probability of success on any given trial, times q, the probability of failure on any given trial. And do note that that entire quantity is underneath the square root. So you will need to multiply n, p, and q, and then square root that product. Okay, so very straightforward formulas to use. Now, let's go to this example where we were looking at the probability of people leaving a tip when they were dining out. We had six people who were dining alone, and from experience we know that the probability that any lone diner will leave a tip is only about 0.7. It's about 70%. Okay, and so let's say that we wanted to find the mean and the standard deviation for this particular distribution. So the mean would be equal to n, the number of trials, which is 6, times the probability of success, which is 0.7. And if we multiply those two values together, we get 4.2. And this tells us that in our group of 6, we expect 4.2 people to leave a tip. Okay, that's what we expect. This, by the way, this 0.2, it's so tempting to round that either up or down. You know, 4 people should leave a tip, 5 people should leave a tip. We actually leave it alone, even though clearly you can't have 0.2 of a person. This is where, you know, you'll be listening to a news story and they'll talk about how the average family has 2.3 children. That's where the 0.3 comes from. It's just an artifact of the formula. We go ahead and leave it like that, even though clearly we can't have 4.2 people that will leave a tip. That is technically what we expect just by the numbers. Okay, so we just leave that alone. We don't do any rounding there. The standard deviation is equal to the square root of n times p times q. So again, our n is 6, p is 0.7, which makes q, q being the probability of failure, 0.3. Right? If the probability of success is 0.7, the probability of failure has to be 1 minus that, so it would be 0.3. And then from there, you can just plug that right into the calculator. 6 times 0.7 times 0.3, take the square root of that, and you're looking at about 1.12 for our standard deviation. Okay, 4.2 for the expected value, 1.12 for the standard deviation. Now, that is one way to do this. That's how you would do it by hand, and it's actually very straightforward. If you did want to do this in the calculator, what you would do is first you would have needed to have put the binomial distribution into your calculator. So you would put the numbers of successes into list 1, and you would have the calculator compute the probabilities for all of those numbers of successes and put them in list 2. You should see the video for doing that if you're not sure how to get that done. But we put that in there. And then to find the mean and standard deviation for that distribution, we're actually going to use one variable stats, which is the thing that we normally use to find mean and standard deviation. So you'll press the stat button, press over 1 to go to calc, select 1 variable stats. If you have the new operating system, you'll see a different version of the screen here. But if you have the old operating system, this is the screen that you will see. And next to your 1 variable stats, you need to press 2nd 1 to get list 1 to pop up, comma, 2nd 2 to get list 2 to pop up. Okay, so 1 var stats, L1, comma, L2. The L1 points out that that's where we actually have the possible outcomes stored, 0 through 6. But the calculator also needs to take into account the probabilities that are stored in list 2, because not all of those outcomes are equally likely. So it needs to take that into account as well. Then we press enter, and we can see there is our X bar. Your calculator always labels the mean X bar because it doesn't know if you're dealing with population data or sample data. In this case, we have population data, so it's mu is equal to 4.2, same thing that we got using the formula. And down here is the standard deviation, 1.12 approximately, same thing that we got using the formula. So you can use either the formulas to do this or your calculator. Both are pretty straightforward. And that's how you do it.